Here we go. Judgment day for Sheffield United and Wigan Athletic on Survival Sunday. And for the final time this season, Sheffield United walk out onto the Bramall Lane turf.
Heskey works it left and now Kilbane. And into the box it goes. It's a low one. Chance of a shot and a goal. A nightmare start for Sheffield United.
Jagielka for Montgomery just outside the penalty area. For Jagielka again, he tries to cross and you've got one step. Jonathan Stead has scored for Sheffield United! 6 yards out in front of the cup! Sheffield United are alive again in the Premiership! Incredible. West Ham leading at Old Trafford. Who would have predicted that? Tevez has got it as well, just to make matters worse. Will ban over this free kick, left-footed, whipped it over towards Heskey! And is there a hand in there? Penalty! It's Unsworth, runs up to the ball, left-footed, and finds the bottom corner! Wigan have hope again! Sheffield United 1, Wigan 2!
Flick ball forward, here's Webber, he's onside, he's 1-on-1. Danny Webber! Off the post!
One goal, that's all. One goal is needed. Sounds easy. At the moment, Sheffield United struggling to find it. Sheffield United have been relegated from the Premiership. The Blaze players sink to their knees and the tears will begin to flow.
When you look back on it, is there still a certain amount of, I can't quite believe this has gone on?
Yeah, very much so, yeah. Bitterness as well, you know, I think we've, you know, it's difficult from my point of view without, you know, people saying it's sour grapes, but some of the teams that have played against some of our rivals over the last few weeks have been so decimated, you know. I think other teams should have been involved more on the last game of the season, but you can go on and on, can't you? You know, the decision of the commission by a guy who's never been in football, chaired the commission and come out with the great words that he didn't feel it, you know, that the West Ham fans should be hurt, you know. But any other time of year, they would have been points deducted. He wants to be in Sheffield now. He wants to feel how we felt on Sunday night, and they really haven't got a clue, you know, it's a shambles.
You know, I think it's been a good ride. I think we've surprised a lot of people, including ourselves. I think, you know, there's been obviously a lot of high points, but, you know, finishing on a low point, which is, you know, still, even now, hard to take. But I think, you know, whatever happens, I think you've got to take positives out of everything. You know, I'm a firm believer in that. And I think, you know, everybody's devastated at the minute, but I think we've got to look back, you know, and pick all the good points out of this season.
It was a truly heartbreaking end of a dream for Neil Warnock and the Blades, as a bitter taste would remain over the circumstances by which Sheffield United found themselves relegated. But along the way, there's been some terrific games, great goals and individual performances, which promises much more is still to come. Let's look back now on a season's highlights and the Sheffield United Premiership story. For manager Neil Warnock, the serious business of reinforcing his squad started in the summer of 2006. He's able to bring the likes of Claude Davis from Preston, Rob Hulse from Leeds United, Mikel Legettwood from Crystal Palace, and the unknown French striker Christian Nardé. To the backroom staff, Neil Warnock was delighted to welcome a highly respected coach, the ex-Manchester United and England legend Brian Kidd. Off the pitch, ground improvements were taking shape as well, with the new Westfield Health corner stand being completed in July and providing an extra 2,000 seats. After a successful pre-season, the Blades were fighting fit and looking forward to life in the Premiership. The inaugural match back in the big time was Liverpool at Bramall Lane.
Neil Warnock beginning his touchline ban today. Suited and booted. Liverpool get us started. And Sheffield United's life in the Premiership well underway. There's Hupia. Looking for a ball out to the left. This is Risa. Kenny goes committed. And a sliding challenge from Eiffel has left Risa down on the deck here. Morgan, it was clearing away, but Risa in some trouble. Definitely onside from the ball forward from Hupia. And when Kenny didn't make the challenge, Eiffel did. And there's the end result. Reese's afternoon ends early. Fowler looks to try and poke it through. Might break here for Gerrard. Morgan's there to handle. Rather unfortunate for the Blades captain. And the referee, Rob Stiles, shows yellow to Chris Morgan. Ball to hand rather than hand to ball. Gerrard and Aurelio look at this free kick. Which one will it be? Aurelio tries one and tipped over by Paddy Kenny. Really strong fingertips from Paddy Kenny. Delicious free kick from the Brazilian. The save was just as good. And Sheffield United going towards the cop in this second half. Foul there. And Sheffield United will get a free kick early on from Camp, the offender. So Blades free kick. Unsworth and Tong over. It will be David Unsworth to ping it in towards Hulse! And Sheffield United have arrived in the Premiership with an almighty bang! It's the summer signing from Leeds, Rob Hulse, who instantly achieves cult status at the Lane with this goal. Unsworth's free kick, and Rob Hulse to thunder the header home in front of the cop. Great delivery, but what on earth was happening in the Liverpool defence? 1-0 to the Blades. What have Liverpool in response? Gerrard playing in a more central role in the second half. Give and go with foul. He's got beyond Morgan, but was he tripped? Well, the referee's had a look at it, and he's given Liverpool a penalty. And I'm not sure if any contact was made there between Morgan and Gerrard. But Liverpool have a route back into this one in controversial fashion. Chris Morgan certainly went for the ball, didn't get it, but didn't seem to get Gerrard either. And now Robbie Fowler has the chance to square the game up for Liverpool and deny Sheffield United three big points on the opening day. Fowler against Kenny, stuttered run-up, calm as you like, and Liverpool back in the game at 1-1.
There's no way that's a penalty. He's given advantage, if there is any foul in the first place, then he's given a penalty. He's given everything, hasn't he? I mean, that decision, it wouldn't have been given anywhere else, innit? And there's nothing to referee in the game. Disappointed.
Striker Rob Hulse was delighted with his move to Sheffield United and getting a debut goal against Liverpool.
Yeah, it was nice, you know, obviously coming to a new club and on my debut, it was, you know, really great day for me. I don't think I'll ever forget it. Always nice to score on your debut just to settle the nerves, and I think it went some way to helping me and I think the rest of the lads to just settle into the Premiership a little bit and realise that, you know, we are capable.
Obviously mixed sort of emotions, you know, the team did fantastically well, maybe to have won the game, but unfortunately the ref decided to make up his own version of the penalty, but we were quite happy with the point at the end of the day. First time we'd had sort of that many people in Bramall Lane for a long time, you know, the new stand was in, the fans were buzzing, and it was a great day.
We were unlucky really, I mean, you know, going about referees, but I've never known a penalty given for intent before, and, you know, Rob Stiles this year, you know, we've gone down with one goal, and the penalty at Man United he disallowed as well. You know, I can't speak. I suppose everybody says it's sour grapes, but never a penalty, Gerrard's. And the word intent, he just said that after. Initially, he told us all he'd caught him. It wasn't till he saw the television replays that he changed it to intent. He make things up as they go along, don't they?
The Blades were away from home for the rest of August, with visits to White Hart Lane and Craven Cottage, both of them ending in disappointment for Neil Warnock's men. With United rock bottom at the end of August, the Blades look forward to starting September with a home game against Blackburn Rovers. United went into the match with just 1 point.
Here's Armstrong. Oh, he's done well to get beyond Savage. Really well. It's a terrific ball as well. And Rob Hulse is in behind. Real chance. Oh. He should have hit the target. Rob Hulse got his angles all wrong. Now, United with defending to do here. Lifted in towards McCarthy. Push on him. Was there by Unsworth? I think there was. And the referee points to the penalty spot. Mike Dean, no hesitation from him. Ball played in. Little shove there by Unsworth. Emerton's penalty. Saved by Paddy Kenny. The referee wants to sort something out here in the penalty area. Kishnishvili and Rob Hulse being spoken to. Smile between the pair. And now Unsworth can take the corner kick. And still Kishnishvili grapples with Hulse as Unsworth sweeps it in. And the referee, I think they have spotted something. He has. And Sheffield United given a penalty. Kishnishvili was warned before the corner was taken. And Mike Dean, for the second time in the game, points to the penalty spot. And it's David Unsworth who has the opportunity to score at the top end of the lane. But saved by Friedel. Would you believe it? Two penalties, neither scored. This time it's Unsworth who misses. Looking to get on the end of this now. Was there a use of an arm there by Lucas Neal? Well, the linesman had a good view of that, and the referee has given yet another penalty. Another sensational twist. The linesman had the greatest view. Now, can Sheffield United make this the third penalty of the game count? Rob Hulse this time. He'll score, won't he? Saved by Friedel! And Quinn on the follow-up can't score either. Well, these two certainly need to go back to the training ground and work on their penalty taking.
Blades' new signing Claude Davis is a man of few words, but he did find time to talk a little bit about life in Sheffield, and in particular on his new manager Neil Warnock.
Yeah, especially the facilities. They have great facilities here. The coaching staff, different at times. They have the ups and downs, but it's great being here. Enjoyed everything so far.
And Sheffield is a place, is it somewhere that you've got used to living?
I'm living here, but I haven't really been out in Sheffield because I'm like a quiet lad. From training to my house to my games, That's basically my day.
Just before the Blades home game against Reading, Nick Montgomery underwent an ankle operation to correct a bone problem. It was really a frustrating time for the enigmatic midfielder.
Well, to be honest, I did everything in after playing most of the games last season and missing out the last couple through injury. I came back pre-season really fit, did all the running, everything. And it was a day we were supposed to play Stocksbridge, the first pre-season game. I just went over my ankle in training and later on that day I could hardly walk. I struggled on for a few weeks and finally had a little piece of bone that had come off my ankle, so that was disappointing. But I decided that I needed to go in and get the operations, take it out and get on with my season. So obviously that was frustrating for me, seeing the lads playing in the Premiership and after everything I'd done last year and how long I'd been at the club, I was quite gutted, but I knew that if I got myself back fit and got over the operation that I'd get in the team.
Shoring into the feet of Leroy Lita. Only slight, but he holds the ball up well. And this is Saul! And that's a terrific goal! Gillespie. By Ledgerwood, support left from Armstrong, looking for Akinbaye. Here's Rob Hulse, Sonko blocks the route to goal. Hulse gets in anyway. Oh, wonderful finish. Sheffield United are back in business. Rob Hulse with some magnificent centre-forward play. There didn't seem to be a way through. Somehow he's held off Sonko and then squeezed it in past Hanneman at the near post. It's 2-1.
Next up, a midweek cup tie against Neil Warnock's former side Bury, and a chance for Christian Nardé, the French striker, to score his first goal for the club. The Premiership season was always going to be full of firsts for Sheffield United, including a first ever trip to the Emirates Stadium and Arsenal, where Colin Kazim-Richards was delighted to make his first full start.
I came on here against Blackburn, give me a little teaser. It was amazing. But then to play at the Emirates Stadium, my first start, you know, boyhood Arsenal fan, dream come true. Couldn't ask for no better debut than that.
What were you like? Nervous?
No, I don't get nervous before a game, but you know when we line up in the tunnel before we go out and then I see Henri standing next to you, I was like, whoa. It's like, yeah. So
did he say anything to you?
Nah, you know, he was just Henri. Henri's Henri, you know. Mm. He was just ready to go out, you know, and we was ready to go out.
What have you seen in him? What is it that made you want to shell out the money for an unknown like him?
Well, he's 150,000, which is loose change in the Premiership, and I just felt he was worth a gamble. He's got something about him. He's cocky, arrogant. He's probably sometimes a little bit too arrogant, but you know, you have to have gambles on certain players, and I didn't think there was a gamble. I thought if he didn't do it, I can always get rid of him. But he's contributed well in the squad and you know, shown what he can do.
The highlight of the month came next. It was a late kickoff against Gareth Southgate's Middlesbrough.
What's more, it's bounced out for Kazim Richards here with Tongue alongside in one way and Hulse getting forward the other. Kazim Richards, Hulse onside for Sheffield United. 1-0. Rob Hulse again. He is their man. The Blades number 9 has pierced Middlesbrough. And Sheffield United have a precious lead on home soil.
Tell you what, it's a brilliant run from Hulse. It really is, because they were defending a corner. And he would have been back there helping out. And he has burst a gut to get forward and get on the end of that ball from Kazim Richards. And it's a great finish, it really is. He doesn't mean to bobble this one over Mark Schwartz. Hits it into the ground, gets a bit of luck, but deserves it for the run and the energy that he's put in to make the ground up. He must have run past 4 or 5 blue shirts, white shirts, and get in there. And I think he'll be rather happy with that.
He is very happy, he's very pumped up. Sheffield United have 3 goals in the Premier League this season. Rob Hulse has 3 goals in the Premier League this season. Oh, an early ball for Yakubu, who's onside here, and Kenny has stayed, and Yakubu has equalised! Route 1, 1-1. On defending by Borough, Mendieta. Viduka ran back into trouble. And that could be costly. Tong. Weber. And away by Davis. Jagielka! Oh, what a goal! The winner, surely, from Phil Jagielka! Sheffield United prepared to toast their first Premier League win.
What a hit, Peter. What a fantastic strike from Phil Jagielka. I mentioned earlier on in the game that Neil Warnock has a lot of honest players. This guy does have the quality to perhaps go and play for a bigger and better club, with all respect. I think you've just seen evidence of that there. Weber does very well to jig around in the box and create something. Now he's got so much to do from here. It's a thunderous strike, and Mark Schwarzer is powerless to do anything about it. As soon as it bounces there, I'm thinking, hit it. It's bouncing beautifully on the half volley, and he could not have hit that in a better spot. If he has another 1,000 goes at it, Mark Schwarzer cannot get anywhere near it. What a goal, and what a moment for him.
What happened in your mind?
It just came out and I was in two decisions whether to head it back in or take it down on my chest. I took it down on my chest. No one sort of came to challenge me, and I thought, well, why not? And why not turn into a goal? So I was obviously ecstatic.
When you do something like that, what goes through your mind then?
Not a lot, really. You're like a big kid. Just ran over towards the cop, slid down on everyone before. No, everyone was sort of, pushing my head into the turf, laughing and joking, and everyone seemed to be buzzing.
And for you then to get that first win at home, a massive step, isn't it?
Yeah, definitely. It sort of kick-started our season. We after that game, we believed, we knew we deserved to be in this division and sort of kicked on from there.
So September ended with a win, and with that, Sheffield United climbed out of the bottom three for the first time and moved into 17th place in the Premiership. The month of October began with two away games. A 0-0 draw against Manchester City earned the Blades a vital point. Then, disappointingly, they suffered a 2-0 defeat at Everton, where Claude Davis was controversially sent off.
To Johnson, Andy Johnson, pulled back by Claude Davis. And it's red.
Johnson gets in front of Davis. Well, I think Davis is very unlucky here.
Well, Neil Warnock is fuming. Claude Davis has exited. It's James Beattie! It's 2-0 Everton! His second goal of the season from the spot. He did it against Wigan, and he's done it here against Sheffield United.
United then crashed out of the Carling Cup. Former Blades boss Steve Bruce brought Birmingham City to town, and despite goals from Adi Akinbaye and Nick Montgomery, United were thumped 4-2 at home. United ended the month of October with one of the most eagerly anticipated visits of the season. It was the billionaires of Chelsea.
Lampard! All the way in, and Frank Lampard gives Chelsea the lead just before half-time. Questions here possibly about the goalkeeping. Paddy Kenny unsighted and just couldn't get there. Play towards Kalou. Robin. Chelsea have runners in the middle here as well. Ballack pulling towards the far post. Here is the German 2-0. Easy as you like. Michael Ballack extends Chelsea's lead. Good knockdown from Kalou. Robin managed to keep it moving. And when the cross was delivered, Ballack was there to power home. Happy days for the special one.
So after 10 games, the Blades had just 6 points on the table. With Charlton and West Ham beneath them, United were desperately chasing Watford, Newcastle and Manchester City. The Blades were still desperate to find their first win away from Bramall Lane as they went up to the North East for another late kickoff against Newcastle United.
Webber.
Danny Webber! Saved by Harper, Hulse going in there, and Harper has pushed it away.
A lot of space for Danny Webber to get the turn in when this ball comes in. Look at the acres he's got around him. Good save by Harper, hasn't had a great deal to do, but what came in he dealt with.
Montgomery. In by Cossack, back by Webber, good football,
Ledger Wood. They've played some decent stuff here, Sheffield United.
Great strike. Liggerwood, not known as a left-foot striker, but there you go, that's not far off the back of the net.
Here's Montgomery. Webber! Danny Webber scores Sheffield United's first away goal of the Premier League season.
Webber pulls off his marker. And there you are, that's the problem for Craig Moore. Doesn't get tight with Webber, diving head up. And yes, quite a happy bunch of players.
Ledger Wood. Spoon forward here for Quinn, who's onside. And hit the post. And then was pounced upon by Harper.
Quinn does well because he makes sure he gets in front of Craig Moore there. Stops him.
Credit to Harper.
Look at them just pouring out. Just pouring out.
It's a very proud moment when we get our first 3 points back in the Premiership away from home. And when you see lads that have been with you nearly all the way, it's even more special.
Yeah, it was nice. I'd had a week off ill. I'd had a week off ill, not trained all week. And then Gaffer was just about to pull me off at Newcastle after an hour because I was flagging and managed to get a goal. And it was just nice, obviously, that it was our first Premiership away win.
It was a great cross as well, wasn't it? Perhaps you wouldn't have expected it to come where it did from, Nick Montgomery.
No, I didn't. I didn't expect it at all. I just thought, get myself in the box and it might arrive in the box at some point. But Monty put a great cross in and I was just delighted, like I say, to get on the end of it.
Bolton were the next visitors to Bramall Lane. They were flying high, third place in the league, with 6 wins so far on the season. They thought they were set to make it 7.
Cleared long by the visitors here. Jagielka can't see it out. And Duff will hold him off and score for Bolton! Bramall Lane stunned. And the least popular man in the ground has opened the scoring. El Hadj Duff gives Bolton the lead. Davis, giving away to Quinn here, he's hustled out of it, and Bolton will come again here, options in the middle, goes beyond everybody, Tal, good save Kenny, had to be alert and he was, keeps it down at 1-0, good cross, and a great save from Paddy Kenny. Into the area, Leary only as far as Davis, Anelka, options here for Bolton, Davis picks it up again and drives one and scores! It's the lifelong blade who extends Bolton's lead, and Sheffield United staring down the barrel of defeat here. It's going through his mind, I wonder. Magic Wood, and now Kazim Richards. Sheffield United looking for a route back into this game. Nardé. Magic Wood's crossing towards Hulse! Yes! Rob Hulse on target once again! Sheffield United have hope again! Is this the start of the fight back, I wonder? Good strength from Nardé. Legitwood's cross, Rob Hulse with a bullet of a header. Squeezes his way between two Bolton defenders. And thuds that one home. Big Sam down from the stands to take a closer look. And Webber will try and chase onto this. Jaskalainen committed. Kazim Richards to Ben Ward. Oh my word! Colin Kazim Richards! His first ever goal for Sheffield United. That is special. Jaskalainen can't believe it. But Sheffield United, after being 2-0 down, are all square at Bramall Lane. There was no apparent danger when Jaskalainen got this one away. But only one thing was on Kazim Richards' mind, and that was to score, and that he did in some style. What a finish. Curled to perfection. Bolton come again. Anelka. What's he got in his locker here? Well, that was close. But Sheffield United just about survived. Blades need to be strong. Bolton throwing everything at them here. Cross into the middle. Chance here for Fai! What a save! Paddy Kenny! How crucial could that be? Anelka, danger not clear yet, tries to bury his way forward, and the referee blows up for a free kick. But what a moment that was for the Blades goalkeeper. Fai denied.
The cross was difficult to deal with. And look at the gaping goal that Fye has to aim at. But Paddy Kenny somehow scrambles across to keep it level at 2-2. Coswick's clearance. And there's the full-time whistle. Sheffield United get a very, very priceless point in a game that they look like getting nothing from. But two goals, one from Hulse and a terrific strike from Colin Kazim-Richards, rescues the match for Sheffield United.
From the moment it came back, you knew it was going in?
Yeah, from the moment it left my foot, I knew it was going in, you know, because like, that is what I wanted to do. A lot of people think that I didn't mean to do it, but I did mean to score that goal. So.
Did they give you plenty of stick about it here on the training ground?
No, to be fair, they saw it afterwards, and, you know, a lot of lads were honest and said, yeah, you did mean to do it. At first, they was giving me a bit of banter, but when they saw it, they did admit that I didn't mean to do it. So.
Next came one of the most eagerly awaited fixtures of the season for players and fans alike. The likes of Ronaldo, Rooney, Scholes, Giggs, well, I could go on all day. But basically, Manchester United came to Bramall Lane, but the Blades gave a debut to young midfielder Nicky Law.
Geary down the left-hand side, tries to play it for Kazim Richards, who went the other way. Kazim Richards will chase it forward. Ferdinand gets it away only as far as Geary, and back to Colin Kazim Richards. Level with the edge of the box. Here's Derek Geary. Right boot, swings it back post. Gillespie with a header. Oh, yes! Keith Gillespie scores with a header across goal from the right side of the six-yard box into the bottom left corner. Van der Sar couldn't get there. It was Geary's cross, Gillespie's goal, and would you believe it, at Bramall Lane, Sheffield United lead Manchester United by a goal to nil.
Well, incredible stuff. What a fantastic ball across, and Gillespie just buries a great header. I've always said, head the ball back where it comes from. That was the perfect header. But I looked straight to my right and watched the cop's reaction, and what a reaction. That was absolutely fantastic. What a great time to score a goal. We haven't had the ball a great deal, but you know, we've scored. It's all about half chances. Let's relax and let's hold on to this lead.
Plays it to the right-hand side, and Neville just outside the penalty area. Left foot across in towards Rooney. Good first touch. Great finish. Perfection from Wayne Rooney. Manchester United back in the game. And in the blink of an eye, Wayne Rooney has steered it past Paddy Kenny, who looks bemused on his goal line. Nothing he could do. Great control. Great composure. It's Wayne Rooney. It's Manchester United back in the game. Blades 1, Manchester United 1. Ever faced by Hulse, who's in a right back position, crossed in far post. Rooney waiting for it. Rooney! He scored! Wayne Rooney on the volley, 6 yards out. I suppose it was only a matter of time before Sheffield United's resistance was broken. It's Wayne Rooney again, his 7th goal of the season, volleying in on the angle, 6 yards out, and the Premiership leaders in front at Bramall Lane. Sheffield United 1, Manchester United 2.
And there was more controversy for United as they went to Upton Park and West Ham United.
Law can't believe their luck and their misfortune. Well, as the chance falls to Law, you expect him to hit the back of the net. But he really snatches at his shot. And it's not a good attempt by Nick Law. The youngster really should have put that into the back of the net. Green couldn't get that. And it's been ruled out. Coslett was sure that he had got an equalising goal then.
With away points proving tough to come by, midweek trip to Vicarage Road, even in November, already looked like a relegation six-pointer.
Close in, and Morgan stabs it behind.
Took a deflection which sent him the wrong way, but manages to stop it and cleared the danger.
And there is a great chance for Nardé, who's headed it against the post.
You just need to make sure you really hit the insides of those posts.
Morgan's got forward, so Shitter's got to go back into his own penalty area. He'll be more familiar there. Francis couldn't bring it down. And a chance for Weber, and Hulse was so right on top of the goalpost and managed to hit it.
There's a driving in a box. It's driven across. You know, I think actually Demerit might get a touch on that.
Weber looking to get it back from Jagielka. It wasn't the best ball, though, by the Sheffield United man. Still got it, have they? Gillespie has done well. That's a free kick. Rare yellow card in his career.
Can't stop himself, makes contact, and can't have too many qualms about that.
It's Gillespie who delivers. Oh, against the underside of the bar and in! And it is Weber who scored it.
That's good centre forward play. It's Morgan who gets the header in the first place. A decent save by Lee. Certainly not anywhere near over the line, and Weber has to react, has to get there first. There's Neil Warnock, he's well happy. I think they deserve it, Sheffield United as well.
Yeah, I think I thought it was excellent at Newcastle. We went up there and Weber scored the goal. I thought a difficult time to go up there with the crowd, you know, the situation up there, but that was a super win, and like you say, Watford was a real hard-earned win, especially after the disappointment of not getting anything at West Ham with that last minute, what could have been an equaliser. So yeah, there's been good points, but we haven't really been good enough, if I'm honest, away from. I think it would have took us this season to then bring in three or four quality players to enable us to, you know, to, I think, to get more points on the road. But we're not on our own. You look at some of the teams that have struggled away from home. You know, I think Tottenham only won 3, and some of the other teams have not even won that amount. So it's not just ourselves that has a problem, it's the quality of our position as well.
By the end of November, Neil Warnock had already made available for loan David Unsworth, Alan Wright, Chris Lachetti, Neil Shipley and Paul Eiffel. And all but Lachetti would be picked up by other clubs over the next few weeks. As for the league table, United were still in the bottom three, still chasing Newcastle and Blackburn, with Watford and Charlton firmly rooted.
Kozlov chips it in. Rob Hulse on the edge of the box tries to turn. Comes towards Stephen Quinn with a left foot shot. On the volley, Scott Carson tips it away. It'll spin out by the corner flag. It's a throw for Sheffield United.
Well, it's a good start from Sheffield United once again, but that's a great confidence booster for young Stephen Quinn. I mean, to get a shot on there, and he started the move as well.
Charlton breaking forward. Now they got a lucky bounce. Jagielka trying to get back, but Andy Reid gets away. Edge of the area. Now it's squared for Darren Ambrose. Great chance for Ambrose. 6 yards out. Oh, amazing save from Kenny, but it's scooped in. And Reid has got it to give Charlton the lead against the run of play. 17 minutes in, after Paddy Kenny did his best, but he could only one-handed palm it back into the path of Andy Reid. It is Sheffield United 0, Charlton Athletic 1. Gillespie's corner from the right-hand side. In towards Morgan with a downward header, and Carson managed to tip it round. He was diving, I thought, despairingly, but somehow he managed to get there. It's a corner again.
Well, that's a great header from Morgan, but as you rightly pointed out, Carson is a top-class goalkeeper. It'll take a bit to beat him.
Can United finally get back in this game after all of the opportunities that they've squandered? Gillespie's corner from the right, in towards Morgan! And they are level! Sheffield United deservedly back on level terms with Charlton. Gillespie's corner from the right-hand side, Morgan leaping high to head home in front of the cop. It is Sheffield United 1, Charlton Athletic 1.
Yeah, great header. Timing of the run was perfect. Good ball in. It's important to say that the service was good. Keith Gillespie taking that responsibility again. Knocked a great ball in, but what made the goal was the timing of his run. He got it in there. Well, let's get that. Keep it going. Keep creating chances. Every chance of winning this game now.
Chris Morgan with his first goal of the season for Sheffield United.
Crosslock's throw. Cleared away. Got a drop here for Gillespie! Oh, what a goal! Keith Gillespie! What a sensational way to win the game! No way back now for Charlton Athletic.
and Keith Gillespie treats us to a moment of magic. What a stunning, stunning strike. Great technique. Arched his back and thumped it away past Scott Carson. Right into the corner. Bang.
It was an important goal. You know, the timing was probably pretty good, being at the last minute of the game, and you know, it sort of gave us a real kick, you know, at the time, because I think we'd just beat Watford on the Tuesday, and you know, to beat Charlton on the Saturday gave us, you know, 6 points within 4 days and gave us a real big lift. And you know, it's always nice to score, but you know, just to score, you know, in front of the cop end as well was a nice feeling.
Technique wise, could you have got it any more right?
I don't think so. You know, sometimes they just end up in the stand, and fortunately it was my lucky day and I ended up in the sort of top corner, so I was pretty pleased with that.
Barros wide on the left hand touchline, goes in towards Sutton, back to Barros on the edge of the box, and then striking towards goal, Davis, and the shot comes in the end from Stylian Petrov, who scores for Aston Villa.
Davis just inside the Blades half, he rolls it to this near right hand side. Gillespie went for it and Petrov went for it, both missed it, but it's Petrov who profits, crossed him with pace, a bundle horse, Sutton, great save, Kenny, super stop, now it's turned in by Cahill, the centre half, saved again by the Blades goalkeeper. Heroics from Paddy Kenny to keep it down at 1-0, but Sheffield United right up against it, and possibly this is the worst they've played this season in the Premiership.
Kozlok's long throw in towards the 6-yard box, Stephen Quinn! Sheffield United level, and the youngster on just his second Premiership start fires it in front of the cop. Dreamland for Stephen Quinn. He scores for the Blades. It is Sheffield United 1, Villa 1, 5 minutes into the second half.
Well, one of the long throws has actually paid off. We've got the first header in, and he's the one to react. He's been threatening to score. It was a nice little touch. It may have got a slight deflection, but the important factor was that he got into the right position.
It is level, and that's something that United didn't deserve on their first half performance. But they have come out of the blocks very quickly in this second 45. We'll see Christian Nardé on very shortly. I would think it'll be Nardé for Weber. Here's the throw into the feet of Stephen Quinn. Back out to Geary. Neat little back heel. Stephen Quinn at the byline. He's won a corner. Great play between Geary and Stephen Quinn.
Yeah, two experienced players there in the Premiership. Combined well, persevered. If you get on the outside of people, you'll always win something. And that's exactly what Stephen Quinn's done. Corner kick. Nice to see a little bit of variation, something on the near post.
Gillespie takes it short to Stephen Quinn. Back for Gillespie at the angle of the box from the left. Looped high to the back post. Up goes Morgan, heads it down. Weber! Danny Weber on target in front of the cup for Sheffield United. As the Blades come from behind, Weber turns it in from close range. It is Sheffield United 2, Aston Villa 1.
Good strike, wasn't it? The went far post, I was hoping for near post, but I think the big difference is that we're reacting to the loose ball. I'm pleased for Danny Weber, not having a great game, but he just maybe needs that goal to just give him a bit of a confidence. Maybe we're not making that change now.
I think he actually had his back to goal as the ball dropped for him, he just hooked it in off the top of his right boot, yeah, past the keeper.
He's just turned it round and turned it on its way there. It was going that way. He's just give it a bit of a helping hand. And
great awareness.
Yeah, it is. He's just put it in the danger area.
Forward comes McCann towards the edge of the box for Aston Villa. Off to Stephen Davis. Davis chips it in, looking for Sutton. Sutton with a header. Drops 6 yards out for Barros. And it's level again. Within a minute of Sheffield United going in front. It is all square at Bramall Lane. Route one for the visitors. And Villa are back level through Milan Barros at Bramall Lane in the Premiership.
Having made a tremendous impact himself during the last couple of months, right-back Derek Geary couldn't be more pleased with the way that things have gone for the Irish contingent at the club, and particularly for his young friend Stephen Quinn.
Yeah, I was delighted for him, to be honest with you. He deserves it. He's got a great career ahead of him, and it's well documented what him and Alan's been through this season with their parent, with their mum and that, and to get a goal like that, I was absolutely delighted for him, because it will obviously give him a major boost.
You're pretty tight, aren't you, the three of you?
Yeah, we're good friends. Obviously, I know Alan since I've come over here, so a good 10 years and that, and I lived with him and that, and Stephen's come over now, and he's doing well, and Keith's obviously doing well as well, but obviously Irish tend to not stick together but be close friends on and off the pitch and all, so yeah, it's good we are close friends.
A battling performance away at Wigan Athletic brought a much-needed 3 points.
They may well be smiling now, but who will be smiling come quarter to five? Webber. Zoo for company. Gillespie supporting. Cross looks too deep. There is a man over it, Stephen Quinn. Quinn's delivery. Hulse! Somehow Rob Hulse has flicked that ball in, and Sheffield United are ahead at the JJB. Gillespie's cross initially was overhit, but when the ball ran loose, Stephen Quinn had the presence of mind to roll it into Hulse, who with a little flick of the right boot steers it beyond Chris Kirkland. Free kick lofted in. Sheffield United looking to get this ball away. Here's Lanzat! Good save, Paddy Kenny. Really stung the palm to the Blades keeper. McCulloch can't keep the follow-up down. Struck with some venom. Puzzle. Oh, he's been robbed by McCulloch, and Wigan could be in here. Real chance for McCulloch to square it up, and Paddy Kenny to Sheffield United's rescue again. What a let-off for Rob Coslock. Great save by the legs of Paddy Kenny. Gillespie, Hulse and Webber making runs forward as well. Good save, Kirkland. Webber! Oh, and Kirkland somehow manages to make the save. It should have been two. Gillespie peeled away to the right-hand side. Kirkland does well with the first, but even better with the second, but Webber knows he should have finished it. Tension personified. Kirkland forward. Wigan trying to rescue this. Put it down. And Chris Morgan has stayed down. But why? Takes a lot to keep this man down. Well, let's have a look at this. Challenging with McCulloch. And Bosch.
Another three great points there against a team that notoriously you'd struggled with over the years.
Yeah, we did. And Rob Hulse took his goal well. You know, young Quinny, young Stephen Quinn, we'd brought in. You know, I gave him out on loan last year, Rotherham and MK Dons. He came into the squad and was a bubbly, full of life. And you know, obviously it got harder work for him later on because, you know, you come back down. But he was on a high then, and a great cross for Hulse's goal. And we defended well that day. I thought we deserved it.
And Chris Morgan ended up a little bit of a mess in that game.
Yeah, he did, yeah. Fortunately, it didn't affect his looks.
What else could you want 2 days before Christmas? You guessed it. A long, long trip down to Portsmouth. But once again, Rob Hulse was on the score sheet. The result, however, was not what we were looking for.
Towards Hulse, great chance, goal for Sheffield United. And Rob Hulse scores for the second week running, and that's a real stunner for Portsmouth. What a start for the Blades.
It's all about the ball, though. Hulse gets on the end of it, the fans are delighted. What a start from Sheffield United. They keep the ball alive. Webber does so well, just keeps it alive, lays it out now to Quinn. Does very well, then Geary just gets onto his right foot and just pings it to the far post. Sol Campbell just gets caught underneath the ball. It's a nice little tap in for Hulse. Great little move, fantastic delivery though by Geary. Neat little header. What a flying start by Sheffield United.
Rob Hulse hadn't scored away from home all season until last week. Now he's done it two in 2 weeks.
With the festive season in full swing, next up a Boxing Day clash with relegation rivals Manchester City.
Now Ireland, all the way through and in. A crushing blow for Sheffield United with just 12 minutes remaining. And in this already key game at Christmas time, Manchester City ahead.
Really cruel game. I couldn't believe how City got out of it, I'm honest. I think they had 3-1-0 wins in a week. Mm. The way we dominated the game was, you know, another disappointment, you know, with Joey Barton getting sent off. The game before, so I should have missed ours, and the Premier League saying they don't sit over Christmas. scandalous, really. And I thought he was instrumental in keeping them going when we were really on top. And a wonderful goal from Ireland, but no consolation because we dominated it from start to finish.
Coming off the back of two defeats may not have been the ideal time to face Arsenal. And when the team sheet was handed in, there were certainly a few raised eyebrows in the press box as Neil Warnock gave a starting role to Christian Nardé. But in typical Sheffield United fashion, it was a case of on the day, cometh the man, cometh the hour.
Kazim Richards. Blaise looking to open Arsenal up here. Kozluk, Nardé almost got on the end of it. Early warning for Arsenal. Kozluk with the throw. Half cleared. Leggett Wood. Going to break here towards Alan Quinn. Great chance. Failed to take it. Gillespie. Montgomery dispossessed and Arsenal build again. Baptista for Rosicki. And Sheffield United doing their best to clear. Appeals for a handball, play continues. Here's Nardé up against Touré. He might get beyond him. Lehmann committed. Nardé! Oh, yes! Christian Nardé has arrived in some style in Sheffield 2. What a goal that is! And Arsenal given a real French dressing down. All started on the edge of their own penalty area. Quinn's ball. Great strength from Nardé, left Touré in his wake, and Lehmann had no chance of getting there. The Blades in dreamland here, and Christian Nardé's first ever goal for Sheffield United comes against the mighty Arsenal, one he will treasure for some time to come. Not happy, is he? Now, Arsenal with some defending to do. Now Paddy Kenny's got a problem. This looks serious. It's a routine goal kick. He's left the place goalkeeper in some discomfort. And no goalkeeper on the bench. But that is the man who would have to take over. Should Kenny have to leave the field of play? He has done it before. But for now, Kenny will hobble on. And still, Paddy Kenny is troubled by this groin problem. And this looks to be the end of Paddy Kenny for tonight. So with the Blades 1-0 up against Arsenal, they now lose their goalkeeper, and not for the first time in his Sheffield United career, Phil Jagielka will don the goalkeeping gloves. Maybe a quick word of encouragement from Paddy Kenny to Jagielka. And we feel now that Sheffield United will really have their backs to the wall, and he could be a very busy man. Standing ovation for Paddy Kenny as he leaves the field. Hopefully that won't be a long-term problem. But Arsenal have a corner, and it's a deep one. And it's punched comfortably away by Phil Jagielka. Early confidence booster. And Percy tangling there with Davis. Arsenal managed to work their way through. This is Baptista, and now Van Persie! And Jagielka to Sheffield United's rescue. And a stop that Paddy Kenny would have been proud of himself. Baptista tried to squeeze his way through, and it breaks to Van Persie. Jagielka did really well. He was well off his line, but managed to lift the ball over. How long they are away from a momentous victory at Bramall Lane. Turn up the volume, he says. And they respond. A quick prayer might just help. Time ticking down, and Sheffield United still leading Arsenal. Davis with the clearance, but it will go for a corner. Not finished yet. You can feel the tension in here. And now Lehmann's up as well for this corner. Last throw of the dice for Arsenal. Van Persie just swinging in. Header towards goal. Baptista was up there. Cendros tried to get there, but the referee has seen enough. And Sheffield United have beaten Arsenal. What a sensational way to finish 2006. Who would have believed it? Paddy Kenny had to hobble off. Phil Jagielka had to take over the shirt. Christian Nardé's goal just before half-time, enough to settle the contest. And Sheffield United back three big points in the fight for Premiership survival. What a night. A night where you have to say you were there. And they will celebrate long into the night.
Quick word on goalkeeping as well. Did you enjoy your stint in this year?
Yeah, I was hoping I wouldn't have to bother in the Prem, but you know, it was fantastic. I went in goal for, you know, about half an hour or so. The boys in front of me did fantastic, didn't have that much to do. And it was nice to beat the Arsenal 1-0 at home. We'd not done it for a while, so extra special in that respect.
I suppose it's a good thing to stick on the CV, isn't it?
Yeah, definitely. Adding to, you know, the number of positions I can play, and like I say, half an hour against Arsenal, we'll go straight in there.
I don't think some of the lads could play two games in 3 days, and we brought one or two fresh legs in, but they were magnificent, you know. And it was a special game that night, because, like you said, the atmosphere was electric. Arsenal, you know, one of the first games I remember as a kid, seeing the mighty Arsenal down here at Bramall Lane. And the attitude was absolutely spot on, and Christian Nardi's goal was top notch. And, you know, he's been a little bit of an enigma this year, you know, because he hasn't been able to start games, but he's changed games, and he'd be better for it. But the way he turned and put the goal away was fantastic. And then the way we defended, and obviously the circumstances with Jagielka going in goals, with Paddy coming off and making a good save. And it was just like Roy of the Rovers stuff. It was probably the best moment of the season for me, I think, that.
There was one sour note to the victory. Following a tussle with Gunners striker Robin van Persie, video evidence deemed that Blades captain Chris Morgan should receive a three-match ban.
He let himself down against Arsenal. It was nothing much of muchness, really, what he did, but he's still wrong, and we got punished for it, you know, three games at the wrong time, really. And he's still got to, you know, he's got to realise the responsibilities, but he has been a lot better, and he's been a good captain.
Did you need his leadership through those three games? Did you miss him a lot, do you feel?
I thought we did at that time. He was playing really well, and like anything else, you don't want to change anything just for the sake of it. And it was disappointing for me to know that he's got a three-game ban for a really innocuous. You know, when you look at the sort of challenges that he himself had to put up with, and Angel doing, you know, grievous bodily harm without getting three games, it just defeats me when, you know, some of the officials and decisions that's gone against us there.
It was a fantastic victory that will be remembered for years to come, which saw United end the year in 15th place in the league. 2006 certainly was a good one for United, but in the very busy month of January, it was far from plain sailing. The year began with a disappointing trip to Middlesbrough, and despite a Phil Jagielka penalty, the Blades began 07 with a 3-1 loss. With the transfer window reopened, Neil Warnock dipped into the market, bringing to the club striker Jonathan Stead, midfielder Ahmed Fati, defender Matt Kilgallen, and the unknown Luton Shelton. Any hopes of a good cup run in the Premiership were to be dashed. League One side Swansea City came into town and trounced the Blades 3-0. The next visitors to Bramall Lane were Harry Redknapp's Portsmouth, but it was Neil Warnock who was dishing out the debuts. At 36, Chris Lacetti was handed his, and also new signing John Stead joined him on the team sheet.
And over halfway it goes, won back by Stephen Quinn, who angles the ball into Rob Hulse, 35 yards from goal. Here's Derek Geary on the overlap, whips one into the box. Jonathan Stead with an immediate header, and that is stopped by David James. Montgomery flicks it forward, Lachetti nods it down. Here's Davis in the box. Davis tries to play on, referee's given a free kick, and Primus will be penalised again, and he's walking a tightrope here. Stephen Quinn, left footer, clips this one over the wall. What a goal from Stephen Quinn, and he spins away in celebration. That was a Premiership quality finish from a Sheffield United youth product. He clipped it into the top corner, and Sheffield United lead here at Bramall Lane. It's Stephen Quinn's second of the season. 21 minutes on the watch. It's the Blades 1, Pompey 0.
Well, a wonderful free kick. It was there to be hit. It was perfectly set up for a nice left footer to curl over the wall. I'm glad he hasn't gone for power. He's got it there. Great accuracy. Right in the top corner. Beautiful free kick.
Stockers. There's a mistake at the back from Davis. It's all over the place. It's going to be put in. And Sheffield United have shot themselves in the foot, and United have thrown it away at Bramall Lane. It's the Blades 1, Portsmouth 1.
When you think back to your debut against Portsmouth, what springs to mind?
A very energetic game. I'd had a couple of months down at Derby and in the Championship, and playing regularly and playing a lot of games, but you don't realise how the pace, you know. I've had a couple of seasons away from it, and you do tend to realise quite straight away, you know, how quick it is in the Premier League. And I really enjoyed it. I had a decent game, and you know, I just felt like I felt comfortable again in the Premier League, and that's where I wanted to be.
Well, I hadn't given up on it. But you know, I started to wonder, you know, if it was ever going to come. But I had chances to move elsewhere, but I just didn't want to leave, because it's a great club, and the chance to play in the Premiership was too good to turn down, even if it's wait longer than what I wanted to do.
The Medeski Stadium has not been a happy hunting ground in recent years, and once again controversy reigned as Keith Gillespie made one of the shortest ever substitute appearances.
Look at this, there's a real battle going on there now. I reckon Gillespie has gone in there on a hunt, and there was a bit of a movement from the arm, and this referee, remember, produced the fastest ever red card when he sent off Kevin Pressman after 13 seconds in a draw against Wolves in Division 1 back in 2000. This could be similar. Gillespie is in trouble here. Now he's going to talk to his assistant, because his assistant had the clearest view.
Well, if he's seen this, then I think Gillespie's in trouble.
Gillespie went straight to him. It was in full view of everybody. Now Gillespie, his heart must be... Oh, he's gone! Keith Gillespie has been sent off after, I would imagine, 10 seconds of being on. Yeah, now it is going to kick off here. Hunt is being spoken to.
Oh, another one.
Another one. It's continued, and Gillespie is furious.
Well, this is amazing.
Keith Gillespie, just to remind you, had been on the field of play about 10 or 15 seconds. This is why he was sent off. Now, just watch closely. He was sent off for that.
Well, it was just a bit of jostling. Hunt is certainly leaning into him, and he lashes out, and you raise your arms, and you make contact.
Watch this. Watch the linesman's flag immediately go. Well, it is, and the linesman's flag is up within 3 seconds.
Well, I wondered how much did the linesman see of it, and how clear was his view of that contact, and he certainly saw it, and he interpreted it right, and it's an unbelievable act from Keith Gillespie. Well,
pure stupidity, and Neil Warnock will have no defence. Warnock is, if anything, he's honest now. Oh, now it's going off on the bench again. Well, this is getting completely and utterly out of control.
This is Wally Downs.
It's Wally Downs.
Wally can be a little bit fiery.
Wally Downs has gone. Is Warnock going as well down here? I think Warnock's gone too. Well, this is staggering. You have to look at Neil Warnock, right, because he almost egged Gillespie on then.
Well, he was certainly having a real go at Stevie Hunt. And he's saying that Stevie Hunt lashed out with his leg, and certainly the Reading camp aren't happy with that, and they're standing up for their players, but there's no real need for Wally Dowse to get into Neil Warnock's face. And
well, what a day. Now Nade's in there, there's certainly a player he can score here, and he does. What a gift. And Steve Coppell is not a happy man.
They didn't look comfortable. This is a tactic they often use towards the end of the game. They try and come out, but they read it late, they misjudge it, and Nade stays in there, and he benefits from an easy goal.
There's one bad bit, I suppose, for you this season at Reading. What do you say now when you look back? You've obviously seen a million replays.
Yeah, I was, it was sort of the red mist that ended, but yeah, it's just one of those things. I'm disappointed with myself for getting involved, especially so early, coming on a sub, but it's gone now, and it's one of those things you just put in the back of your mind.
Well, I think Reading's Reading out, seems to be always getting trouble there, don't I? Ex-United players who fancy themselves, I think it's only natural, isn't it? But it was an incident out of nothing, really. I think you can see what really happened when I didn't even get charged with it. It was ridiculous. It's funny, like, I suppose, when you see me. Thankfully, I had some water in my hand, so I didn't get involved.
Next up was a return to Bramall Lane of the prodigal son. Michael Brown brought his Fulham side to town.
And now Quinn chests it down on halfway. Here's a chance for Stead. Got Quinn inside him, approaches the edge of the box. Still Stead into the path of Quinn, onside. Quinn one-on-one. Oh, just round the post. Clip the post. Clip the foot of Niemi. Fine save. Corner kick. 0-0. And it's midway inside the Fulham half, a shade to the left, as Colin Kazim-Richards floats it in. It's towards that back post again. It's headed away. And the clearance is completed. Here's Quadrup. Montgomery comes in and wins it again to Stead. Back to Montgomery. Montgomery down the left-hand side, drives one in, Stead with the control, still Stead with a chance, left-footed! Jonathan Stead scores his first Sheffield United goal, and the Blades take the lead at Bramall Lane! Good work on the edge of the area from Nick Montgomery, and there was Stead to get the ball back, and then left-footed, smash it past Antti Niemi. 23 minutes on the watch, Sheffield United 1, Fulham 0!
Well, if I was Mr. Coleman, I would be very angry. When I see a 6'5" centre-half, Zach Knight, just dangle a leg out, and Stead's gone straight through him and powered past him. We said before the game, we felt the two centre-halves were lacking of pace and maybe lacking stature. Not in physical stature, but in playing ability. And so far, they have been found wanting. Now, the Blades have to really push this now physically, move the ball quickly and get them under pressure as quick as they can.
Kazim Richards with a throw, and Stead will chase it down, and Zach Knight will try and get it clear. Stead keeps it back out wide. Kazim Richards clips a high ball in the box looking for Hulse. Pierce gets it clear, but then it's not at a cross goal, and Stephen Quinn might latch onto this on the angle. Pulls it back in, Michael Dow! He's scored! And Sheffield United have extended their lead! There was a ball across the face of the area by Michael Tong, played back in from a tight angle by Stephen Quinn, and there was Michael Tong to stab it home for his first goal of the season, and Sheffield United have a two-goal cushion. They lead Fulham in a massive game at the foot of the Premiership by 2-0.
Well, as we said, it was important that they not only followed up the first goal with another goal quickly, because it now, Fulham, they look totally disarrayed. Players are pointing fingers at each other. The manager's throwing bottles to the ground. Now, once again, as far as I'm concerned, you go at them again now and try. And if you can get the third one, then you can kill this game off in the first half. And it's important that they do.
Well, this is a rare position for Sheffield United. To have scored twice and not conceded is something they are not used to in the Premiership. But they lead 2-0 here.
It was a great night, wasn't it, at Bramall Lane?
It was, yeah, and an important victory, to be honest, because I think just previous to that, we struggled against Reading away, and we needed to, Fulham are a team that, you see now are around us, or have been towards the end of the season, and you need to try and beat the teams that are going to be down there with you, and I think we've done that quite well this season.
What about the first John Stead Sheffield United goal?
Yeah, it was good, yeah. It's always good to get off the mark, you know. You don't want to be, the longer you go without scoring, you know, when you first joined the club, it gets harder and harder, like it was at Sunderland. So to get off the mark, it was brilliant. And I scored previously against Fulham, so it was nice to get another goal against them, and especially at the line as well.
What happened? What do you remember of it?
Monty cut inside and played a pass inside to me. My touch was in front, and then somehow it squeaked through. I think it was that night that came out, and then it was just bouncing a little bit, and with the left I could see it was easy just to lift it and just smashed it really, the roof of the net, and keeper had no chance.
What feeling do you have when you score? What do you do? What goes through your mind?
It's a great feeling. There's a little bit of relief in there as well, because you're coming off a game having scored, you know, you've done your job and that's what you're there for. So it's scoring goals that keeps you going and keeps you progressing. But there isn't a better feeling in the world at all.
So coming out of January, the Blades remain two places above the relegation zone, and the next game at Ewood Park, John Stead had a particular reason to celebrate his return to his former club.
Towards Hulse, who got a flick on, and it's an equaliser for Steph. Well, the X factor applies. John Stead returns to Ewood Park with a goal. And what a good finish this is, and good for him. He didn't over-celebrate. He just put it in the net, ran off, didn't milk it.
Number 8, John Stead.
It's a terrific header here. Hulse, strong, times it well. Good first touch and fantastic finish. That again is a man in form, confident, good strike play by his partner, and just a cool finish. Lovely little touch there, good first touch, could have blasted it, could have panicked, didn't. Finishes it absolutely brilliantly.
Inactivity was becoming a problem for United. The only home game of February saw the Blades play host to Tottenham Hotspur, and despite bitterly cold weather conditions, a very entertaining afternoon.
Now ball over the top, and Genus is in here for 1-0 Spurs. It's there! Jermaine Genus! The game only 2 minutes old. Quinn. One of the Blades got in response up against Chimbonda. Still he goes, Stephen Quinn. Armstrong. There's the foul. Kazim Richards with the free kick. It's a good delivery. Hulse is there. Off the line. How close can you get? Spurs saved by the woodwork. Kazim Richards with the corner. Here towards Hulse, headed out, and in! The Blades are level! Rob Hulse! Kazim Richards with the corner, ever so deep, and Rob Hulse does brilliantly to climb above Michael Dawson. And Paul Robinson, the Spurs goalkeeper, just had too much traffic ahead of him and just could not get there. Kazim Richards. Chimbonda, now Quinn, now was he brought down? He was! Martin Atkinson, the referee, pointing straight to the spot, and Sheffield United have the opportunity here to go ahead. No doubt, was there? Phil Jagielka against the England goalkeeper at the top end of Bramall Lane. Jagielka, straight down the middle, no mistake, and Sheffield United in front here.
They're an honest bunch, and I've put together a side that don't know when they're beaten and they're enjoying it. You can see they're enjoying it.
A 4-0 defeat at Liverpool followed, and that meant the Blades remained in 16th place at the end of February. But with tough fixtures on the way, United started to look behind them. With Watford now bottom of the table, West Ham slowly picking up form inspired by Carlos Tevez, Charlton and Wigan were both close at hand. Moving into March, finally making his home debut against Everton was the Egyptian international Ahmed Fati.
Glorious sunshine as Everton look to find a way into the match here early on. Header across goal, and it's Claude Davis who clears away. And that ball appeared to have gone out, and Cahill's header eventually dealt with. Kazim Richards here does well. Low ball in, Hulse! Yes! Sheffield United's leading marksman on target again. He does have that killer instinct, demonstrated here when the ball was played in. He had the presence of mind to get across his marker. The deftest of touches. And the ball nestles in the back of the Everton net. Real predator's finish. Now Davis under pressure. Kenny under pressure. A real mix-up. This is Johnson. And Kenny, does he pull him down? He does. Andy Johnson wins a penalty for Everton. People have talked about his ability to go down easily all week. Arteta to face Paddy Kenny. This for 1-1. Only just. Only just. The linesman says the goal will stand and that the ball crossed the line. Now Hulse down the other end. Now shouts for a penalty here. And the referee says no. He was well positioned to have a good look at that. Julian Lescott, all arms on Rob Hulse. Well, make your own mind up.
Disaster struck in the following game away at Chelsea, not in the 3-0 scoreline, but when United's star striker and leading goal scorer Rob Hulse slid into the goalkeeper Petr Cech and then found himself with a really nasty looking injury. It looked innocuous at first, but as the replays show, Hulse was in a great deal of pain, and after spending a long time on the surface at Stamford Bridge, Rob Hulse was taken away. An x-ray showed immediately that he'd snapped his leg. It'd be the season over for Sheffield United's leading light.
That's part and parcel of, you know, that's my game really, going in, trying to get in front of defenders and getting into the near post or pulling off to the back post. So that's unfortunately at Chelsea, it just didn't quite go to plan, but it's just one of those things.
You're still on sticks right now, but how is the leg?
Yeah, it's good, you know, it's getting a lot better. I'm 6 weeks gone now, so... like I say, I've been round on the bike this morning, first time out. I've been in the bike in the room, but it's nice to get outside and a bit of fresh air. And it's a lot better. I'm putting a lot more weight through, and I see the surgeon this week. So hopefully he'll wean me off the sticks sooner or later. And, you know, I can start progressing. Everyone seems to be quite pleased with how I'm getting on and been positive from the first day, basically. You know, nothing I could do about it. Disappointed to miss the season and miss the running, but... you know, that's life, and you just get on with it, and I'll be fitter, and I'm sure I'll be stronger and fitter next season, raring to go.
Do you think you'll be ready for the start?
That's what I'm hoping for. Whether that's going to be, you know, whether I'm being too optimistic there, I don't know. But, you know, I'm hoping for the start of pre-season. I'll definitely, a week before, I'll be able to start running, a week before pre-season.
A 1-0 defeat at Bolton brought to an end a disappointing March that saw the Blades slip within 1 point of a relegation place. And Charlton finding form, West Ham under the power of Tevez starting to get their act together, only Watford looked certainly down. With Newcastle United really struggling to get results, hopes were high of another 3 points. But despite another Christian Nade goal, it still ended in a 2-1 defeat for the Blades.
Gillespie, Blades 2-0 down here. Nade, Gillespie again, Good ball in. Kazim Richards didn't quite get hold of it. Montgomery will. And here's Nardi! Oh, yes! Sheffield United back in the game. Back at 2-1. And Christian Nardi gives Sheffield United a glimmer of hope. Montgomery does really well. And Nardi sticks it away well. Can they get a second?
Phil Jagielka was once again awarded the Supporters' Player of the Year for the third successive time. A great achievement, but his mind, like the rest of the squad, was certainly on West Ham United. That game taking on increasing importance, a real relegation six-pointer. But with the pressure on, the players turned in one of their best performances of the year.
Stead's flick. Nardi looks to go beyond his man. He was pulled back by Ferdinand. And this is a free kick in a great position. Nardi looking menacing. And Ferdinand just did enough to prevent him from moving forward. Michael Tong! Oh, what a goal! Michael Tong with a violent hit! What a sensational drive on the free kick! Didn't even see it. That was vicious. The crossbar will rattle for the rest of the afternoon. My word. Tevez. Chance here. Good save, Kenny. Good strong hand from Lucas Neal. The defender did well. The keeper did even better. Such a presence. Tangling there with Tevez. Brave header from Morgan. Morgan's flick. Stead's in here. The Blades turning the pressure on. The big men are up from the back. That could also be a target on this corner kick. Gillespie to sweep it in. And it goes towards Jagielka! 2-0! Phil Jagielka! With the header that Green just had no chance of getting to. How crucial a goal could this be? Great lead. And Green nowhere near it. West Ham come again, but that was sloppy. And this is Jonathan Stead. Nothing on in the penalty area. Might just run this into the corner, but maybe he has other ideas. He does! Oh, that is special! That is special. Jonathan Stead had absolutely nothing on, but somehow he's found the bottom corner of Rob Green's goal, and Sheffield United in dreamland here. How big a victory this could be in the battle of the Premiership strugglers. When it mattered, Sheffield United have shown up at the party here. Stead turning Ferdinand and unleashing a shot beyond Rob Green. Has a look, sees nothing on, and thinks, well, may well have a go myself. How he did.
goals, 3 points. Sheffield United can almost see survival.
When you look at that win over West Ham, did you think, this is it now, we're on our way?
Well, I just thought it was important at that timing. You know, we did well. We've been doing well against teams around us, and they're the ones that you want to win. And so it was a massive win for us, and, you know, give the lads a lot of confidence.
A midweek trip to Old Trafford is one that both players and fans look forward to. Manchester United come into the game fresh from their 7-1 hammering of Roma. The Blades determined to make sure that didn't happen to them. And although it finished 2-0 to Manchester United, Sheffield United put in a real performance.
You'll probably have to say playing at Old Trafford. I know we got beat 2-0, but I think we did really well that night. And playing in front of all them people is a great honour, really, and to play against, you know, the best people in the world.
You look at, you know, your likes of Rooney, Ronaldo, you know, they just, the ability they've got, you know, even, you know, Paul Scholes as well. You know, I think for me, them three are just fantastic footballers. You know, you can look at all three of them, and, you know, that's why I think Man United have won the league. You know, there's been a lot of important players for them, but I think if you were to ask anybody, I think them three would fire straight off the tongue. I think they've been exceptional this year. What a fantastic place to play football. You know, you just think of them lads who are lucky enough to walk out every other Saturday and play there. Great arena, but I'll tell you what, I don't think there's been many places where I've played this year that have been as loud as this. You know, I think the atmosphere that we've created, I mean, within Bramall Lane this year has been unbelievable, and, you know, something that, you know, I've not experienced for a long, long time.
4 days later, and trailing to a first-half Charlton goal, John Stead was back in action, and his second-half strike earned the Blades a point in London, and it kept them out of the bottom three, remaining 2 points ahead of the Addicts.
Well, here's Stead, an opportunity! And a fantastic goal for Sheffield United! That really changes the picture now.
Fantastic shot from John Stead. He capitalises on a bad mistake from Ben Thatcher. He allows the ball to go under his foot. Here's the ball. Ben Thatcher should have dealt with it. John Stead smashes it past Carson, giving him no chance. He gets absolutely maximum power and accuracy with his shot. It's a tremendous strike. He hit a beauty last week, didn't he, with his left foot against West Ham into the corner of the net. This one with his right foot.
The penultimate home game was against Watford, who'd been relegated the weekend before. But for United, points were vital. They went into the game in 17th place, and they needed to make sure of victory.
Looking for options, Michael Tong's in space if he needs him, but he goes long for Nardé, who wasn't really watching. Doyle clears it away, forward it goes to Tong, to Christian Nardé. He's marked by Powell. Now Christian Nardé onto his right boot. He will play it square in towards Phil Jagielka, out to the left touchline, and Tong. Opportunities now for Sheffield United. Tong just inside the box, Tong, yes. Shoots! It's been deflected in! Sheffield United have taken the lead! They rode the early pressure from Watford, and Michael Tong's effort, which took an enormous deflection to go in past Foster, flew in the top corner. It's Sheffield United 1, Watford 0.
Well done, Michael Tong. Actually, he's got wide, he's come in, asked a question of the guy, and struck the ball not as clean as he probably wants, but he's took a wicked deflection over the goalkeeper, and certainly a great time for Sheffield United to score. Now just keep your focus before half-time. Don't give Watford any encouragement to come forward. Wasn't Michael's best shot, but who cares? It's gone in the net, and 1-0 to the Blades.
I think it came off Chris Powell, but nonetheless, it certainly beat Foster, and Sheffield United now lead by a goal to nil.
It was a late kickoff at Villa Park, which meant the team already knew all of the results around them, including a fine 1-0 win for Fulham against an understrength Liverpool, and Carlos Tevez inspired West Ham to a 3-1 win over Bolton. It didn't help. For the first time this season, Sheffield United folded under pressure. They lost 3-0. It was a result that bemused manager Neil Warnock.
I don't think it was turning. I think they were just too good for us on the day, and that's not taking anything away from us. I just thought, you know, you can say tactically, you know, I mean, that's the game we went out to try and win the game. I thought we could get a point easily. But then afterwards you think, well, why didn't we do what we did at Man United and go a bit stronger and not give anything away? I probably listened too much to the fans and tried to win the game. You know, it's difficult because we did find out that Wigan had lost just previous, you know, 5 minutes before going out, so it would have been possible to change it. But the lads were in such a good mood, you know, the training had been good and there were no reason to think we couldn't go and get a point. But by half-time it was all over. You know, it was then a matter of not giving too many away.
And so we arrived back at the final day of the season, and with West Ham not being deducted points for the Carlos Tevez affair, results were vital. The equation was simple for Sheffield United. All they had to do was win or draw against Wigan. For Wigan, to stay up, they had to win and hope for a miracle at Old Trafford, where West Ham, who on paper had the most difficult challenge, needed 3 points themselves. As they say, the rest is history.
So here we go then, the final 90 minutes of the season. It was a long wait for the Blades to get back into the Premiership. Can they stay there at the first attempt? And now coming forward, here's Sharna. That's a great challenge from Montgomery. Breaks though to Heskey, works it left, and now Kilbane. Into the box it goes, it's a low one. Chance of a shot and a goal! A nightmare start for Sheffield United at Bramall Lane. The ball broke into the area and there was a chance. And on the left peg, Paul Sharna was able to dispatch it low past Paddy Kenny.
Jagielka for Montgomery just outside the penalty area. For Jagielka again, he tries to cross and a good one. Stead! Jonathan Stead has scored for Sheffield United! 6 yards out in front of the cup. Sheffield United are alive again in the Premiership. Great ball in from Jagielka. Stead was brave. He's now injured, but the ball nestles in the back of Mike Pollock's net. It is Sheffield United 1, Wigan 1.
What a brave boy. He's sung his head in where he might get hurt, and this is what it's about. You know, he's been very, very brave there, and I hope he's not too hurt badly there. It was a real big collision with Mike Pollock. Mike Pollock came out, was never going to get there, and Stead's got his head in front of the goalkeeper, who's given him a real whack after his head had been brave enough to put his head on it. He knew he was going to get a whack there, and that's fantastic. It's gone into the net, and there's a big melee in the middle of the, where the two physiotherapists are obviously attending to the players that have been injured. But a very brave boy, and well done.
John Stead, their talismanic figure, is down injured right now and struggling by the looks of it, surrounded by paramedics. The stretcher is out in anticipation. I just hope that Dennis Pettit can work his magic here. Stead will be okay to continue. And boy, has that man scored some key goals over recent weeks. The third against West Ham, the equalising goal at Charlton. Wigan, though, have a different kind of a problem here. Ryan Taylor is going to have to go off. So Wigan, yet again, have another defensive problem. And David Onsworth, it will be, to come on. He has played at centre-half for Wigan this season. Looks as though he's going to slot in there now. Incredible. West Ham leading at Old Trafford. Who would have predicted that? Tevez has got it as well, just to make matters worse.
A body blow. Left wing corner, taken right footed. It's deep towards the edge of the box. Headed in towards the box. There's a volley overhead kick from Heskey. Great save, Paddy Kenny.
Sharna won the first header once again, and then they've switched off, they've allowed Heskey, they've not looked when they come out, and that is a wonderful, wonderful save from Paddy Kenny, a fantastic acrobatic save, and he's palmed it out for yet another corner. Sheffield United have got to start being stronger and more physical at set pieces.
And now Morgan comes in. McCulloch though was too cute for him as he nicks the ball off his toe, and now Heskey with a neat little flick should be cut out by Tong. It is, and the Blades are just inside their own half. Flick ball forward, here's Webber, he's onside, he's one-on-one. Danny Webber! Off the post! It's going to be cleared away. Comes back to Gillespie, still the Blades have people in the box. Gillespie wide right, can he get the cross in? Fashions it, corner kick. And Webber Well, he's unlucky there, Danny Webber, I think.
It's a fabulous opportunity. It's a golden opportunity. He's through one-on-one. He's tipped the goalkeeper. The goalkeeper's committing himself early, and it's so unlucky. It's hit the post, dribbled across the line for safety for Wigan. They have a corner now, but what an opportunity that was for Danny Webber.
Some days are just not meant to be yours. And with Danny Webber one-on-one, you fancy him to score.
Ball into the box, Stead just couldn't get on the end of it.
Well, I think one or two fans thought he was being tugged at, Jonathan Stead. To be fair to the Blade striker, he didn't complain too much.
Now, Michael Tong wins it back in midfield, a straight ball down the middle, he looks to roll Hunsworth, but the referee has stopped play. A foul by McCulloch on Michael Tong. A second yellow for McCulloch, which means red, and Wigan are reduced to 10 men. One goal, that's all. One goal is needed. Sounds easy. At the moment, Sheffield United struggling to find it. It's happening again. Kilgallen from halfway pumps it in towards Morgan. Flicked header on the angle. Stead! Oh, he just didn't catch it clearly enough, 8 yards out. 5 minutes of time to be added on. That's definitive now. Sheffield United have 5 minutes to rescue their Premiership campaign. Kenny balloons it forward. It's gone back into the Wigan penalty area, brought down by Stead on the angle. 8 yards, cross goal, needed a touch. Gillespie will keep it alive at the byline. Dinked in, hits the side netting. Kazim Richards will take it. Sheffield United have thrown the goalkeeper forward, Paddy Kenny. Last chance, Kazim Richards, and it goes towards Claude Davis. It's babbling around. Kenny was in there.
No, it's a free kick.
Well, that's it for me. That's got to be it.
Yeah, it certainly looks that way. I mean, it's soul destroying, isn't it? And heartbreaking for these people here. And you can see Paul Jewell, he sees it's last second. I think that is it. And obviously, Wigan have defended stoutly, and Blades just the first half, they didn't have the quality. And to lose a goal just before half time was put a massive dent in today. There it goes.
Sheffield United have been relegated from the Premiership. The Blades players sink to their knees, and the tears will begin to flow. John Stead sits in the centre circle, head in hands. But the celebrations begin. It's party time for Wigan Athletic. And after starting the day in the box seat, Sheffield United are heading back to the Championship after just one season in the top flight under Neil Warnock.
When Danny Webber had that opportunity and it came back off the post, can you describe the emotions down there?
Yeah, it was just that split second when he chipped the keeper, you know, the hope, and just sort of went straight away, didn't it? It went, you know, didn't even come back to him. It was inside of the post and went across goal. It was just, I can't really put it into words. It's not like me, that. I know that's not like me, but I just can't put it into words.
It's one of those strange ones. I've listened back to the commentary of it, and you hear the crowd start to cheer as he shoots. And then there's that moment of silence as it hits the post, and then the groan.
I think initially it's going in. I think it's just the last bounce, you know, and the thickness of the post that sent us down. And it is just very, very hard, even now, to talk about it. It's not easy. And I know life goes on, and one or two people have reminded me that nobody died, but it just feels like they have. And it's, you know, when it's in your stomach like that, you can't get away from it. You know, when you go to bed at night, you think about it. And I don't know, you know, until the next ball of the next season's kicked, I don't think you'll forget.
You know, to go down on one goal. I think if it was a point, you know, I think sometimes you can swallow it. But to go down by one goal, it's hard to take. And you know, we're now on Tuesday. It's, you know, 2 days on, and still, I know, I spoke to a few lads this morning, and I think even staff in and around the ground, I don't think people can still believe what's happened. But you know, it has happened. Sooner or later, we've got to put it behind us. You know, like I said earlier on, we've got to learn from it, take every positive we can. You know, I think whatever whatever experiences you have in life, I think it makes you stronger and you've got to learn from them. So, you know, this time last year we were sat here and, you know, we were over the moon. This year we sat here and we're tasting the other side. So we've just got to make sure, you know, this time next year we're sat doing another video talking about promotion.
At a press conference 3 days later, PLC chairman Kevin McKay brought to an end the Neil Warnock era.
So, Neil goes with our blessing. He will be etched in the history and heritage of Sheffield United. Longevity amongst the top two or three since we started back in 1889. He's got a great spirit, loves the club just as much as anyone. And you know, in the 7 or so years since he's been with us, we've achieved so much. We are a Premiership club. We have got an infrastructure that's been led by Neil and his team members that puts us high in the top echelon of clubs in England. It's a great pity we've suffered this setback at this time, but Neil's got that desire to watch United from the touchline, to see us resurrect as we bounce back and become successful again.
From a personal point of view, you know, I wouldn't write back coming back here in a few years' time, Kevin. You never know, things happen like that in football. But
you might be chairman.
I know. But at the moment in time, I've really enjoyed the last 12 months. I think Sheffield United have been a credit to the Premier League, on and off the field. I think to the press and other media. And the disappointing end to the season is not going to take anything away. You know, I don't even feel personally that I've been relegated, whereas the statistics actually say that we have.
In the background, the Carlos Tevez affair had become big news, as Kevin McCabe and Sheffield United took the Premier League to task and then to arbitration to try and beat the drop. United found plenty of friends, support from other clubs, Parliament, and of course from the fans, although both the arbitration panel and then the High Court agreed the Blades had been very unfortunate, neither ruled in their favour. United now continue their fight with a private case to try and get compensation. So after a summer dominated by off-the-field activities, changes were happening elsewhere at the club. Stuart McCall returned to his former club Bradford City as their new manager. And after a week or so of looking for a new man to take the role of Neil Warnock's successor, Brian Robson was named at a press conference and was clearly delighted to be taking on the challenge of helping the Blades bounce straight back to the Premiership.
Well, I'm delighted to take the position, you know, of manager of Sheffield United. Really looking forward to the challenge, you know, to get straight back to the Premiership, because that's where you want to play.
Back in the Championship, but surely one of the favourites to go straight back up. The pressure will be on. The Robson Kidd era began with the sales of Claude Davis, Colin Kazim Richards, and finally Phil Jagielka. United, though, did add academy graduate Billy Sharp, midfielder Lee Hendry, and left-back Gary Naismith. So another season looms and should provide more thrills than spills as United aim for another season of Championship glory.